Path to recovery in the Middle East and Central Asia depend on containment measures, access and distribution of vaccines, and scope for policies to support inclusive growth and address economic scarring. Access and plans vary widely. GCC countries have the most advanced plans and resources and are using a range of vaccine providers. Similarly, a few larger countries such as Egypt, Morocco, and Pakistan are progressing well. Several countries in the Caucasus and Central Asia will also likely be able to vaccinate large portions of their population, but are relying on just one or two providers, which could slow the process. In contrast, large number of countries, particularly fragile and conflict-affected states, are dependent on the World Health Organization initiative COVAX. Supporting these countries to ensure equitable access to vaccine is thus critical, considering their limited healthcare capacity. Vaccine access will play a critical role in the recovery and could contribute to divergent economic outlooks for countries in the region. Overall, for the Middle East and North Africa region, we now project 2021 growth at 3.1%, following a sharp contraction of 3.8% last year. In the Caucasus and Central Asia, growth is projected at 3.7% in 2021 after minus 2.1% growth in 2020. Countries that have implemented effective fiscal and monetary support measures in the aftermath of the pandemic and have space to support recovery policies are better positioned to emerge faster from the crisis. In addition to the challenges in acquiring vaccines, many countries face sizable fiscal challenges as debt has increased by an average of 11 percentage points of GDP in 2020. Thus, most have limited or no space to temporarily sustain higher deficits without incurring significant risk. Consequently, these countries should prioritize spending that will have the largest social and economic impact, such as investing in youth and upscaling the labor force, while also developing viable medium-term fiscal plans to effectively control debt and create space to promote sustainable and inclusive growth. Regional and international cooperation will be critical to ensuring that the existence of vaccines haves and have-nots does not indefinitely persist. Distribution constraints for poor countries should be eased, COVAX funding should be bolstered, and surplus doses should be redistributed to countries where the needs are greatest, particularly fragile and conflict-affected states, so that the recovery can take hold throughout the region, regardless of wealth. Meanwhile, social safety nets should be strengthened to reduce inequality. Finally, countries must not lose sight on the need to build smarter, greener, and fairer economies for the future, which will help accelerate and strengthen the recovery.